Pierce County Juvenile Court is in desperate need of more volunteers to help advocate for kids in the foster care system. Joining me today is Debbie Carta. She is a CASA volunteer. Debbie, what is the job of a court-appointed special advocate?
Well, I appreciate you having me here because I love this work, so I love sharing about it. My job is to be the voice for the child. So when a child is removed from home due to abuse or neglect, the court appoints a CASA, if there are enough, to the case. And so my job is to represent that child and their wishes and their needs. And there's several ways I accomplish that. First, I get to know the child. I visit the child in the home they're placed. I go to their school. I observe them there. I am in contact with their doctor and people who are in that child's life so I can know more about that child. I observe them as they do visits with their parents. And then the next thing I do is interview the people in that child's life. I talk to, as I said, I can talk to doctors, teachers, family, foster parents, parents, extended family, anybody who knows that child, so that I get a fuller picture of what's happening for that child and what their needs might be. Then I take that information and keep careful notes, and then I take that information and create reports for the judge. And the judges are very appreciative of CASA reports because they have important information that is easily read, easily found. So the judges appreciate those reports. And then I appear in court for the child. I speak up for that child and say how they're doing, what their needs are, how they're handling this big event in their life, and how the parents are doing, how they're progressing with the things they need to do. And I make the court aware of what the child's wishes are. That's very important, to talk with the child. What are your wishes? It's hard for a child to speak up in that kind of situation, so I'm that voice for the child.
And you've probably seen firsthand why CASAs are so desperately needed and how much of a difference they make.
Yes, definitely. Definitely.
What kind of training goes into this, and then what kind of a time commitment are we talking about?
The training is excellent in Pierce County. I've been very impressed with it. The initial training was very thorough, and then I'm frequently offered training by professionals in the field. So the training is very thorough and helpful. I always have someone to turn to for questions or concerns if I have a dilemma. So there's a lot of support in Pierce County for CASAs. We're asked to commit to 2 years because a typical court case takes that long to resolve. Mm-hmm. So social workers can change. They frequently do change on a case. So a CASA is the most familiar face to that child throughout that period, and that's a comfort and a security to that child. A case can be done with 5 to 10 hours a month. Mm-hmm. So it's up to the CASA how many children they want to represent according to time, but any amount is appreciated, but 5 to 10 hours a month.
Boy, and what a difference that small amount of time can make. What should people do if they'd like to get involved and learn more about being a CASA?
Go on to just Google Pierce County CASA and get some information. The thing is, I took 10 years from the first time I heard about CASA work to actually sign up. And don't wait that long. There's children out there right now that need CASAs.
Thank you so much for coming in and for all of the work that you do with these kids and making such a big difference.
You're welcome.
All right.